Today I'm going to talk about the inverse square law and how in understanding it will help you and your flash photography. The inverse square law sounds very geeky and scientific, and most people will switch off when it comes to things like this. But it is quite a simple part of how light works, and it's essential to understand it to be able to get the result you want from your flash photography. The inverse square law states that the specified physical quantity, and in photography that's in the case of light, is inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the source. So in layman's terms, as you move your light source away from your subject, it gets diluted. And more than you might think. If you have your flash 1 meter from your subject, you get good settings for the flash at quarter power. If you move the flash away by 1 meter, so the overall distance has doubled to 2 meters from the light source to the subject, you'll have to increase the flash by 2 stops to get the same exposure. Basically, the same amount of light will be covering 4 times the amount of surface as you double the distance. So it will give you 1/4 of the power of the intensity every time you double that distance. Another way to look at it is if you were to change your settings and leave your flash power at 1/4 power, you would have to increase the amount of light getting into your camera by 2 stops. So from f8 to f4, or ISO 100 to ISO 400. And remember, as your settings double or half every time you change by 1 stop, changing by 2 stops will change the amount of light by a factor of 4. So in the example I have given, changing from f8 to f4 is 2 stops of light. So this will double the amount of light coming into your camera twice. F8 to f5.6 will double it once, and from f5.6 to f4 will double it once again. So you will end up with 4 times the amount of light being let into your camera. I've doubled the distance of the flash to the subject from 1 meter to 2 meters, and to compensate for this, I've opened up the aperture from f8 to f4. In photography, it's all about distance from your light source to your subject, and from your light source to your background. Once you know about the inverse square law, there are 3 ways you can use this to your advantage to get the photo that you want. Now, I'm only using 1 light at the moment to keep things simple. I will go into multiple lighting scenarios in a later video in this series, but for now, 1 light will do. Let's say you're doing a headshot. You might want to either lighten the background or darken the background. So once you've worked out the distance from the light source to your subject, if you keep this the same, and then increase or decrease the distance to the background, you can change how that background looks. So you're shooting a portrait and your subject is right next to your background. The light from your flash will bounce off that background and come back into the camera. Now, if you keep the distance from your light source to your subject the same, but then increase the distance between your subject and the background, that light will disperse and not be as intense on the background. So again, we'll look at them side by side and you can see the difference with the background. Everything has been kept the same apart from the distance between me, which is the subject in this case, and the wall behind me, which is the background. So by placing your camera, your light, and your subject further away or closer to that background, you can determine the brightness of that background. When your flash is closer to your subject, it'll be more intense and you will have to adjust your settings to let less light into your camera. In this shot, I had the flash about 50 centimeters from me. The right side of my face is really bright and the left side falls into the shadows really quickly. If you look at the reflections of the light source in my eyes, it's quite big. This is called the catch light. Also, the background is darker as the light is so close to me. If I keep the distance from me to the background the same, but increase the distance from me to the flash to 2.5 meters, to keep the same exposure on my face, I have to increase the flash power to 1/4 and open up my aperture to f4. Now you can see the light is more even on my face and the shadows aren't as dark. Also, the catch lights in my eyes are a lot smaller and the background is brighter. So again, looking at them side by side, you can really see the difference. Moving the flash away from the subject or closer to the subject really can change how your photograph looks. So let's say, for example, you have someone with quite shiny skin. you can move that softbox further away from them to give a more even coverage. Whereas if you want to give a more three-dimensional look, or you want to brighten up part of the face, you can move that softbox closer. So this is where you need to get the balance in getting the right size softbox and placing it at the right distance from your subject. Now this just comes down to experience. All you need to do is start taking some test shots. Get your light, get the softbox on the light, and then fire off a load of different shots with that flash a little bit further away and a little bit closer to see which one you or the subject likes best. The worst thing you can do is light a group of people only to have the people closest to the light really bright and the ones further away really dark. I do have to admit, I've done this a couple of times a long time ago, and I had to do a lot of work in Photoshop and Lightroom to even out the shot to make it look okay. Now, during these times of social distancing, I had to set up a virtual group shot. When the flash is close to the group and placed to one side, it's really easy to get uneven lighting across the whole group. In this example, Mike to the right is almost overexposed, whereas Mike to the left is a little bit underexposed. To fix this problem, just move the light away from the group and change your settings to suit. Then you'll get a more evenly lit group shot. Also, in moving it away, the shadows will normally fall in better places, especially if you're using two or more lights. In the first example, the light was around about 1 meter away from me to the right of the camera, whereas in the second example, I moved it back to about 3 meters away from me and then changed those settings to suit. You do need to be careful about how far you move it away, but in making small adjustments in the distance of your light placement to the subject or subjects, you can really change how the light falls on them. So in knowing about the inverse square law and how the light falls off from your flash, you can use this to your advantage to get the outcome that you want in your photos. Now let me know your experiences with flash photography in the comments below. It'll be great to hear from you. And also if you have any problems with flash photography, I might be able to address them in future tutorials. So let me know about those in the comments as well. And if you want to learn more about photography, click on this one next. Or to binge watch a load of tutorials, click down here. And if you haven't already, be sure to subscribe for weekly tutorials in photography and videography. I'll see you next time.